Good late evening and welcome to my channel. Now, for the first three parts, I have encountered a lot of microphone difficulties where the microphone just suddenly died off for no apparent reason. I hope it's working again now. It seems like it is. I've been running a few extra tests on it, but only time will tell. So I loaded up the game and I'm not sure where I loaded up to. It's not as far as I gotten, but we'll see. I don't think I'm far behind. So basically, I'm in a really old house with
okay.
I'm trying not to be as loud right at the moment because it's in the middle of the night here. But oh, that caught me off guard. So it's I really enjoy this game so far. I'm in an old house, probably during old times, and I'm a painter and I've been making a lot of mysterious, spooky paintings, and apparently they seem to come to life at the moment. And yeah, I'm just gonna... What? Oh, God. I've already played this part. Like, I'm not sure. I haven't gotten that much further, but I can't believe that got to me again. I've been having a couple of hours break trying to solve this microphone issue, and I'm using open broadcast software, and I upgraded to an entirely different version of it, which they say is going to be a lot more milder on the microphone on these sort of issues. Okay. Oh, I remember this part. Oh. God damn it! I think I'm not far behind from where I left off. But basically, there was someone knocking on the door, and what my microphone didn't pick up last time because it was, you know, dead, was that someone was knocking on the door, and I said, "Okay, I'm not opening up," and then it just got brutal. But then I said, well, I'm definitely not picking up now. But, oh, key, yeah. Oh, there we go. Here we go. Okay, someone's coming from the right. It's locked. No. Nope. I'm not opening up. It sounds like someone's stepping into buckets full of water or wood. I don't know. And there's paint on the floor. And, oh! It's a hot summer day, isn't it?
This house is absolutely amazing. But those stairs. With that leg of mine, I think you'll have to carry me to the bedroom once we move in.
I have the microphone on my lap. I hope it's not what's doing the disconnection because I get startled way too easily. I'm just gonna make sure this is properly plugged in from time to time. Okay, it's locked. Okay. I think that's the room that I got to. Oh, never mind. That's. Oh yeah, this is the room I got to. Yeah, this is where I ended.
Are you out of your goddamn mind? What did the doctor just say about straining yourself? You can barely hold a comb. Leave that damn thing alone!
And as far as I remember, my wife had an accident at home. The house was on fire and she was sent to the hospital. And by the look of that bloody wheelchair, I'm gonna assume the damage was quite severe. And we have a record here. I'm gonna put it into the gramophone. This entire room seems to be made of a painting, because when I look at the curtains, I feel like I can just touch the curtains and I can just feel the dried painting. It's like everything is made out of paint. And another of my conclusion was that all of the rooms I was going into just seemed like it seems like each room was a painting, and I was visiting each of my paintings. That was my conclusion so far, because at one point I was warping directly from a room to another. It just seemed like I was walking into a painting, really. What happened here? Ugh. Lots of ink. Alright, so what do I have to do here then? Even this door just looks like it's made of ink. Like everything. Ugh. It's dripping on me. Do I have to play this in at the correct speed? Wait, what is that? Oh, does it mean I can reverse it or something? Dirt, I made a whole room come back. I first noticed the curtains weren't black anymore. Okay, so I can probably go out here then. Yep. Progress. Okay. Don't do this to me. Don't make me go back here. Okay. Hey, you weren't supposed to quit that easily. Okay, what if I... backwards again. Dripping ink again. I wonder if I have to do something while the room is heavily distorted. Or if I have to revert it back to normal. But I can't go out the only exit, like this. I have to... if I can't find anything to do like this... then I'll have to revert it, I guess. Ambiance during a transition is creepy. You can just see the entire door just unmelting. Well, there's definitely something I need to get done in here. There's the violin, I think it is. Yeah, it's... yeah, violin, yeah.
I needed a jar and... oh. And a plastic tubing. I siphoned gas before. I knew how it was done. I stuck the tube in a vein and sucked on it until blood filled my mouth. Then put the tube in the jar and it just kept coming. The taste of copper haunted me the entire night. Why didn't I think of a syringe?
Yeah, it's like... I was so used to seeing bottles on the floor, I probably just ignored it like that. Am I supposed to go out then? Okay. Yeah. Okay, we're back to this room. Did something happen with this picture? With this painting? Yeah, the bleeding flamingos again. And as I was saying at the early parts of the game, hoping that my microphone is working now, of course, is that it's not easy to tell if a YouTuber is acting or not, but oh Jesus, I was sweating so much. It's like when it comes to ghosts and paintings and all things haunted, that's what I find the most terrifying. Things like that. Things that are haunted, things that, like, inanimate objects and you can do nothing about it, like monsters, you can run away. Stuff like that. Stuff like that, but like old houses haunted. That's what got to me about Amnesia: The Dark Descent. It was like the theme at all. It was just perfect to give me a one-way road to a nightmare. Okay, what do I have to do here? Dust mice again. Okie dokie, what's... Oh yeah. Prothesis snatchers. Can't afford a new prothesis. Yeah, this is what he read to me in the kitchen. I wonder where that skin is from, but at the same time... Well, ugh. Ugh. Just gonna make sure my microphone is properly. Just gonna adjust my cable every now and then. Just in case. What else is there for me to do in here? Oh, I can touch the flamingo. Was that behind me? Was that behind me? I apologize in advance for being startled and making squeaky noises or whatever. But yeah, that looks like a corpse of some kind. Like, perhaps that's just my imagination, but. Yeah, I'm not even sure. Oh, this unlocked. Okay. Oh, yeah. These are the items I found. I found that. And it keeps writing on the wall. The dialogue, he says. So these are probably key parts of the story. They are sort of collectibles, and I need to collect all of them. So let's go see what our horror adventure has in store for us. Jump scares really get to me, I'm sorry. Usually I hate jump scares, but I think this game is doing it quite well. Oh, and it's loud, of course. It's really loud. Everything is loud. Where did that come from? Creator's block. How clever. So I am inside paintings then. Oh. Wait, where did the door go? Are you kidding me? It is fooling with my mind. Looks like somebody hung themselves. Should I? There's something around your neck. There's a key. I'll take that. Yes, thank you. And I'll... Okay, I can't close you. What happened to the music? What happened to the music? It melted just like that room from earlier. Mind is going around like that. Oh, this is amazing. Like, every time something like that happens, my entire body just freezes up a lot. It's so well done though. I love it. I might not be able to sleep tonight, but I love it. And as usual, just watching someone else play this is some... It's not gonna be as scary to watch it. I'm just gonna have to say that right away. But if you play it yourself, then you get the entire experience. You get... You're in control. It just does something with your mind. It feels like you're actually dreaming sometimes. And that was gone. That was gone. That door wants to stay open. Okay. A plate and a cup. And upside down. Flapping horror, be quiet. Constant fapping, eating other rats. So this is a bat. I thought the other drawings were of rats. But that doesn't look quite like a bat. It looks like a rat with wings, not a bat. Which I presume to be a mouse with wings. But, eh. Who knows. As I said earlier, I'm not an animal expert. I'm just turning around really slowly because I'm too scared to look behind me. That's when you know you have a good horror game. And I'm pretty sure I was in this room way early in this game. Like, there's a lot of rooms which I recognize. Which I return to somehow. I'm pretty sure these are all paintings which I am in. And if there are creepy paintings in this world, which there of course are. And that's not a comforting thought at all. One thing I also mentioned when I think my... Oh, hello. When my microphone was malfunctioning was that... I'm not sure if these are separate copies of the paintings that I keep finding or if the paintings themselves are moving around. Blind fools. Now that's a creepy painting if I ever saw one. You look like the painting in at the start of the game, in the stairwell. There was a painting just like this. Am I not supposed to touch you? Did you move? Well, the door did not close on me, so I might not have to do something here. Oh yeah, Oh, my mind doesn't work at all when I'm scared. Well, that's a lot of books, you could say. If I ever saw a room full of books, literally. Huh. What? I hope I'm not speaking too lowly. I hope the microphone is picking me up okay. Hope kills the mind. This game kills my mind. I mean, I am amazed, but at the same time when I'm scared, my mind just doesn't work. I like elevators, but in horror games, you never know what to expect. And especially earlier when you were going up a few floors. Ooh, that was creepy. I never wanted to get out of the elevator. But I had to. That's ominous. Bathroom flickering, that's not the good sign, that's not a good sign. Oh, whoa, whoa, no, something is going, oh. Hi there. Silent floaters, they clog the brain. No, they clog the drains. Oh, rats, yeah. Fur in the water. No batus for me. Oh no, baths for me, of course. Ugh, yeah. Hey! What? What? That towel just startled me so much, I thought somebody was standing there. God damn it. That's the thing, that there's not always a lot of things happening in horror games, but you keep panicking. You keep building yourself up, and that's the scariest part. You are the scariest element in a horror game. Your mind is your dangerous enemy. And the same things count for actually going somewhere scary in real life. For the most part, your mind is making it scary, not the environment. Well, you know. Writer's block again, eh? Well, that's a long and religious-like corridor. Is that someone behind me? Like earlier, I was turning around and suddenly there was a puppet flying down. What? Huh? What? Easy to forget when you're scared. But I'm psh. Also, they said that this guy had a prosthesis that his damaged his leg or something. You can hear him limping. As if this wasn't scary enough for going down to the basement. I heard something. I heard something. Cloth just diminishing? The ambient sound is so loud. I heard something. It sounded like something was running far off. Surprisingly loud in my ears. This loud buzzing sound. Something on a wall. let's pick it up. Dangling Dread. That really is not comfortable for my ears. Patient Thirsty. Furry Leeches. Afraid to Look Up. Oh. What? I'm sweating already, although I probably shouldn't be, but I get startled way too easily, so. Your question might be, if you're so scared, why should you play a horror game? Well, that's it. This is one of the few experiences, like, when you're playing a horror game. Like, there's not much you can do, or much that I can do, that makes me feel more alive, sort of. I get sucked into this entire environment. It feels like I'm sort of dreaming, but you know how real dreams can feel. A church tower? Ay-yay-yay. Is gravity still a thing? Or... My God. Oh, okay. Let's get out of here. This is giving me the creeps. This is really giving me the creeps. Don't put the house on fire again. How is the crate not on fire? What's going on in here? What's this?
I needed to remove the flesh from the bone. At first I was lost as to how, but then I sawed it off with a handsaw, boiled it, then put the bone in a mortar.
What's wrong with you?
I had to get one. Obviously, this was not something I had done before. Finally, I mixed the dust with some white paint. Made for a lovely undercut.
Never-ending nightmare, is this? Okay, so this is it's my third item, I think. Out of, I don't know, six? Okay, get out of the creepy basement. Come on, limp yourself up there. There's nothing behind us, is there? Nah. Never was, never is going to be. Yeah, here we go. Sort of zombie? Because that's an eye. Why do you make these creepy paintings? So, three more items. I'm gonna end this part here. Ooh. K. Kitty drawings on the wall. Not sure if this is a good sign at all. But yeah, I'm gonna end this part here. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you.